Did you know that the food on your plate could influence more than just your waistline? It could be shaping your mood, your energy levels, and even your mental health. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Chris Palmer, and today we're diving into the fascinating and complex relationship between diet and mental health. You know, so many people say, eat healthy foods for your brain, but I want to be the first to say, it is not so simple. So let's break down this science together. Diet influences mental health through multiple mechanisms. It can alter neurotransmitter pathways, reduce inflammation, shape the gut microbiome, and even enhance something called mitochondrial function. Now, most people know mitochondria as the powerhouses of the cell, but for readers of Brain Energy, you already know they are so much more than that. Each of these pathways offers insights into how changing your diet might be used as a tool for improving your mental health, even people who have serious mental health conditions. So let's start with some of the basics, and the basics are nutrients. So deficiencies in vitamins like B12, folate, and iron have long been linked to mental health issues. So who might have these issues? The primary risk factors are people who are eating a vegan or vegetarian diet. And that is because B12 and iron are primarily found in animal-sourced foods. Now, that doesn't mean that you can't be vegan or vegetarian, but it means that you need to be mindful of getting the appropriate nutrients. Omega-3 fatty acids, particularly EPA, have been showing promise in mood disorders thanks to their anti-inflammatory properties. Vitamin D, a nutrient that we get from the sun, is also another key player. Turns out the vitamin D receptors are located throughout the brain, and that low levels of vitamin D are often associated with depressive symptoms and many other health conditions. The bottom line is that if you are suffering from chronic mental health symptoms, you should consider getting screened for nutrient deficiencies, and then based on that information, personalizing your dietary plan. This can make a world of difference for people. The second way that diet can impact your brain are the harmful substances that can be found in food. For some people, they have food sensitivities. The clearest example is celiac disease, in which people are highly sensitive, almost allergic to gluten. And that means if they eat grains that contain gluten, they will have inflammation in their gut, and this can lead to inflammation throughout their body, and that can actually influence your brain function as well. Beyond sensitivities like that, there are some foods that contain ingredients that are likely more widely harmful to most humans. The clearest example of this are ultra-processed foods, which unfortunately many Americans are now consuming on a daily basis. It turns out that people who eat ultra-processed food several times a day are 3 times more likely to have poor mental health compared to people who rarely or never consume them. And the study that found this actually controlled for exercise, they controlled for socioeconomic status, and this risk still persisted. So if you are having chronic mental health symptoms, you might want to think about the different foods that you're eating. Some people can benefit from doing an elimination diet where you target things like gluten or artificial additives because these types of dietary interventions have shown benefits for conditions like ADHD, particularly in individuals with food sensitivities. This really highlights the importance of tailoring dietary strategies to individual needs. There is not a one-size-fits-all diet. Some people do quite well with whole grains, while others can be quite impaired with whole grains. So not a one-size-fits-all diet. You know, we've all heard about the Mediterranean diet, and we hear that this is the healthy diet. And again, some people will say, well, I'm following a Mediterranean diet and I still have mental health symptoms, so diet can't be playing a role. Well, hold on. We know from one large randomized controlled trial called the PREDIMED trial that the Mediterranean diet can improve health broadly. This was a randomized controlled trial of over 7,000 people in which they had some people do a Mediterranean diet and they gave them free virgin olive oil and encouraged them to consume 4 tablespoons daily. other people were told to do the Mediterranean diet, and they were given free mixed nuts. And they were told to consume about 30 grams daily, walnuts, almonds, hazelnuts. And the control diet was actually on a low-fat diet, a diet that many people have heard is good for you. Well, it turns out that that low-fat diet is not optimal for health. The participants were followed for almost 5 years. And the main findings that were people who were assigned to the Mediterranean diet groups, both the olive oil group and the nut group, had about a 30% reduction in the risk of major cardiovascular events compared to the control group. They had other health improvements as well, including reduced inflammation, better lipid profiles, and improved blood sugar control. So this begs the question, well, what about the brain? Can the brain benefit from a diet like the Mediterranean diet? We have one trial, the SMILES trial, which demonstrated remarkable improvements in depression. This trial looked at people who were already being treated for depression and took half of them and assigned them to a group that encouraged them to use the Mediterranean diet. The other half got a social support group. The people who were assigned to the Mediterranean diet had about 4 times the remission rate of depression compared to the people who were in the control group. And what this means is that something like the Mediterranean diet, with its anti-inflammatory properties, its impact on the gut microbiome, or maybe some of the nutrient-rich foods, in particular healthy fats, can be really good for brain health. The next thing, which some people are going to consider the polar opposite, is we're going to talk about something like the ketogenic diet. So a lot of the diet warriors will like battle these diets against each other. No, the Mediterranean diet's better. No, the ketogenic diet's better. Ketogenic diet's going to kill you. You're going to drop dead of a heart attack. We hear all sorts of things. But this is where I need you to open your mind to the complexity of dietary interventions. Because it turns out that the ketogenic diet can have profound effects on the brain. And we know this because it is a 100-year-old evidence-based treatment for epilepsy. This diet can stop seizures even when medications and surgery, brain surgery, fail to stop seizures. The great news is that this diet is now being studied for a wide range of psychiatric conditions, including depression, bipolar disorder, and schizophrenia. This diet is thought to enhance mitochondrial function. It reduces inflammation. It changes the gut microbiome. It changes neurotransmitters. And we are seeing results. People with severe mental health conditions are in fact improving their brain health. Some of them are achieving remission, sometimes even off of antipsychotic medications. Our team has reviewed over 50 studies on this that included over 1,900 people, and the results are incredibly promising. This is no longer an anecdote. This is not one case report. This is about 1,900 people finding improved mental health by changing their diet. But it's not just following a healthy diet. It's not just getting, you know, phytonutrients and antioxidants. It's about changing your metabolism. And then lastly, let's talk about the gut-brain connection. This topic gets overwhelmingly complex because there are literally trillions of microorganisms in our guts, and they are doing all sorts of things. They are producing neurotransmitters and inflammatory molecules and neuropeptides that directly impact brain function. Emerging research into probiotics and gut health interventions is opening up exciting possibilities for treating depression and anxiety. Right now, though, I have to tell you, this field is only beginning, and we don't yet have clear probiotics or other kind of interventions or pills that we are recommending yet. But hopefully in the next few years, we will have better recommendations. There is no doubt the role of diet in mental health extends far beyond just eating healthy. By targeting inflammation, mitochondrial function, and gut health, dietary interventions hold immense potential. As this science continues to evolve, diet could become as central to psychiatry as it is to cardiology or obesity medicine or diabetes medicine. So the next time you're choosing what to eat, remember, it's not just fuel for your body, but it is nourishment and interventions for your mind. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Please subscribe to this channel if you want more insights into the science of mental health and metabolism. Thanks.